right, it's been a little while since we last saw each other, and we got a little bit of rain, and I got some work, some real work to do so I could pay the rent. And, you know, so I took a little bit of a break from the Shasta, and we're back on it again. At any rate, I did want to run this by you. You remember I had to remake this piece, both these pieces here and there. It's just a 45 degree angle, and basically it sandwiches right over the laminated piece of plywood and that board, that soundboard that we put in there. At any rate, this just sandwiches over it. 2-inch screws go all the way through from both sides, affixing both pieces together and going all the way through everything. So as you can see right there, there's a screw, and there's a screw, and there's screws underneath also that come all the way up through, and they're just countersunk. I didn't show you this going in. It's no big deal. Just copy the pieces that come out, put them back in exactly the way, you know, unless the old ones are good. But in most cases, in this case anyway, from what I saw, it was just, you know, needed new wood. So I'm doing everything new here. All right. Yeah, and then getting back to the paneling now, I had to remake this first part of the video. You're about to see all this already. See, it's already done now, but you're about to see it go into place. I had to remake this video because the first section, this part here, was all blurry. I've been having a problem with this camera with focusing, and as a result, I hate this camera too. So we're still looking for the right camera. Alright, let's get to it.
Alright, now birch isn't easy to find in most places. I know where to get it here, but I still got to drive 30 miles to get it, and it's expensive, so you don't want to waste it. Our grain is going up and down, and our measurement here on each side is, total measurement is 48 inches. So what we're going to do is cut the sheet in half, and that way we can keep our grain going up and down. We use a half sheet to make this piece and a half sheet to make the other piece, and that'll, in combination, use up pretty much a full sheet. Now it's only it's less than 30 inches in width, so we'll have some scrap, and we'll be able to use that scrap in other places later on, so we'll keep the scrap. You also want to remember to set your skill saw so it's just a little bit thicker than the wood that you're cutting. Finish it. Not easy. With a little practice, those things become easier. So there, we have two half sheets. The grain is going this way, and that's why I did that. If it was going the other way, I'd only make it as wide as needed, but it doesn't go that way. Okay, now we're just going to trace what's there, and we'll have to do a little notching at the bottom when we, before we actually put the piece in, because of that one new piece of wood that I put in the back there. And these used to go all the way down in between the framing, down where the floor is, and they're not going to do that anymore, so we'll be making a notch there. So we're going to make our lines where we know they go. Okay. And even though this is made in two pieces, I'm making it out of one piece. So I'm eliminating the seam, because I'm not worried about saving material as much as they were. Now here, I want to make this a little bit bigger. So when I cut it, I'll leave the line, whereas on the rest of it, I'll cut the line off. Okay? So I'm going to make the line, And I'm going to, when I cut it, I'll not only leave the line, but I might even go a little bit outside of it. If you just flat out don't have the pieces to copy with, you're making them brand new from scratch, it would behoove you to go get a refrigerator or box or something, some big cardboard anyway, and make it a template first. How long could that take? Because you can cut that with scissors and stuff out of cardboard or anything that's easy to cut. Make a template and check the template and make sure it's good. And then go ahead and cut your real piece. Now we'll just continue this line on down. I'll line a straight edge along it. There. Now this is all being done from the back. I know this looks like it's the good side, but it's not. Back in the old days when they made Luan, it was good on both sides. The new stuff that they make now is only has birch on one side and the other side is just Luan. But in the old days, they birched both sides. Imagine that. I guess they had a lot of birch. Fill in there. Fill in there. Okay, we're ready to cut. Round cuts with a square saw again. Same on the other side, pretty much. Shouldn't be any difference in the radiuses. I did cut a little bit on the outside line here, some places as much as an eighth of an inch. Just want to give myself a little room. I can trim that down with the belt sander. There's that piece. It slipped right in. Let's go see if it fits. All right, I got tired of that nail gun. It just doesn't work. It's electric. It doesn't work on a 100-foot extension cord. So I went to air. I I love this thing. So, nice. That works. That I like. And we're going to have a seam going all the way down here, so we can do one there too. The only thing is, you just don't want to miss. So I marked it down here, and we know where it is up here, so now I'll go ahead and use a straight edge and make a couple of marks just so I know where it is. And this gets covered with trim. There we go. We'll put a few in around here. Like I said, in strategic places. Down here we're not worried because the bed's down here. So we can put a couple in here and get it where I want. There we go.